I'm Johnson 32. Brother Anthony's house stands on the side.
All right, give me.
Gray kid, failed your test. Dream girl of your dress. Show her you're the best. If you can cheat the plaintiffs, you can get the prize. The big blue eyes. Skinny little pies and those big blue eyes. Everybody's got the right to be their family. Don't say man life's not as bad as it seems. If you keep your goal in sight, you can point to any fight. Everybody's got the right to be their
family. Sister, I said he,
you wish it better.
Excuse me.
doesn't stop the story. The story's pretty strong.
He said, damn you, Lincoln, you had your way.
Just pour.
You turn your spite into civil war.
Thank you. you find it stirring, inspirational?
Fuck you!
Undecided. And the young lady.
What? Oh, very nice.
Oh, indeed. Perhaps you'd like to buy a copy of my book. It isn't much. Some random musings on the mysteries of creation. Truth.
Break it!
in ourselves that we are underlings.
That was President-elect Franklin D. Roosevelt, ladies and gentlemen, speaking to a crowd of supporters here in Miami. Beautiful, they run far. A group of notables are pressing in around the president-elect car. There's Mayor Anton Cernak of Chicago.
We might have been thinking of it. My name is Czolgosz. Leon Czolgosz, I would like to see you here.
I'm sorry, but I have a train for Kent.
It's gone. I was in the hall last night. I heard your speech. It was very good.
Thank you. The Cossacks of the Chicago Police Department seem to feel otherwise.
They're the violent scum of the world.
You haven't seen much of the world, have you, Mr. Czolgosz?
No. Yes. I have been to Buffalo. Rochester.
Yes? And when were you in sleep?
Last week.
And Rochester?
Week before.
And the week before you weren't up. You have been following me. Why? Answer me, why? To spy on me? To inform on my opponent?
No, but I am in love with you. I am not.
That's different. Thank you, Mr. Czolgosz. Leon, unfortunately, I do not have time to be in love with you. I am speaking tonight in St. Louis, and if I miss my train, the Cossacks there will have to find somebody else's arm to break. Goodbye, Leon.
Miss Coleman, wait. Miss Coleman, I am alone. No one. It's nothing. I'm a grown man, 27, and I have no life. What do I know? Nothing. What have I learned? Nothing. What have I done? Nothing.
I'll tell you what you have done. Since you were a little boy, no more than a child, you have permitted yourself to be brutalized and beaten down, brought to the brink of madness by despair and desperation so that other men, men no worthier than you, might live their lives in ease and comfort. This is what you have done. This is what they have done to you. Am I right? Come, Leon. Come. You are a beautiful woman.
Of course,
Elaine. No, your life has made you beautiful. Your suffering has made you fun. I give my love freely, Leo. If I had time, I would give it to you. But I don't. So instead, I will give you something else. Something you can embrace with more passion than you can any woman.
What is this?
An idea, Leah. An idea of social justice. Of a world in which men are not merely created people, but allowed to live that world.
And this is your idea?
Not mine. Not mine. Good God, I can't go.
Miss Coleman, if you please, I would like to walk into the station there.
It's a free country. That was a joke. You may. They make a servant, Leon. We do not make servants like each other.
Thank you. lover and his slave.
You know, it's really weird. I knew a guy named Charlie Manson back in high school. I also knew a guy named Guy Lombardo.
God, what a dream that.
He was captain of a football team.
Charlie says that football is a form of slavery in which the black man's speed and strength are ruthlessly exploited by the racist ruling class. Charlie says that one day the black man will throw off his chains and lash back at the pigs who have tormented him. Charlie said that in the Armageddon, which ensues, women will be raped and disemboweled, men will be castrated, lynched, and burned alive.
fit me. You think it's working? Let's try there.
It took a little finger, no time to
comrades, long before you shoot the gun. Men the mind and in the steel of wheels, men machines will die. For what? Something will buy. For what? To shoot a gun. I think the length of cost is richer. For in one place, any men before it's done. Just one more time.
Well, if you're hearing this, I guess you're listening now, right? So, with all due respect, deferring to your stature in the world of music, classical and semi-classical. I want to offer you a small piece of advice. Hey, I know what you're thinking. Who the hell is Sam Vick with his fat ass and his tongue on rye to give a shit hot guy such as yourself advice? Well, it's a fact that my unwillingness to compromise my principles and kiss ass, like some people I can mention, has taught me the so-called good life, which others have enjoyed. So be it then, fuck me, fuck you. Listen to one small piece of advice from a true fan. Forget the long hair shit and write what you write best. Love songs! They're what we need! They're what the world needs! Lonely Town, Maria, take the melodies that cherish for a lifetime, timeless strains which linger in the memory and the heart. Love money, what the world needs now is love, sweet love, love makes the world go round. Well, that's it. Bullshit makes the world go round. You know that all too well. A worldly guy such as yourself. You know the world's a vicious, stinking pit of emptiness and pain. Well, not for long. I'm gonna change things, Wayne. I'm gonna drop a 747 onto the White House and incinerate Dick Nixon. Gonna make the news. You're gonna hear about it, and I know what you're gonna ask yourself. What kind of a world is this where a decent stand-up guy like Sam Vick has to crash a plane into the president to make a point? You're gonna wonder if you wanna go on living in a world like that. Well, let me tell you what, you do. And you know what? So you can keep on writing love songs. Yes! There's a gorgeous world out there. A world of unicorns and waterfalls and ice dogs. And you can save it, Lenny, through the medium of your God-given talent. Do it, Lenny. Save the world. Is that too much to ask? Oh, and Lenny, one more thing. When you hear about my death, you're going to wonder if there was something more you could have done. Lenny, you did everything you could. Well, maybe not everything. Maybe not absolutely everything, you know? Maybe one day you could pick up a phone. Just pick up a phone and say, hey, Sammy, how's it going? Hey, in there, Sam, is this fun for you? Along with that, it may take a minute, a half a minute. That was too much, wasn't it? Hurry up your limo, the whole bar, you and your shit-hot buddies had a plane to catch to Paris, France for dinner and a blowjob. Hey, I understand too well, my friend. You're just like all the rest of them. Jonas Salk, Jack Anderson, and Darren, you knew where I was! You all did! And you know what you did? You left me there! You jerk! You shit! You brat! You had your chance! And now it's too bad, like! Fuck me! Fuck you! I'm out of here. I'm history, man. Understand? I'm history. I like to be in America. Okay, by being America. Knock on the door in America. Welcome aboard in America.
You play own songs.
Yeah?
I told you, I just played myself.
Like,
would you leave me alone, please?
Ooh, is this your girlfriend?
Yeah.
Oh, is she?
She's young, all right?
She looks like a whore.
She is a whore, so what? I'm gonna save her from all that.
A little bit.
Yeah. But I mean what it says.
Dear John, I will love you forever. One day you will come for me and you will occupy the White House and the peasants will drool with envy.
See?
This photograph of the Department of Columbia Pictures. Any
picture? Give me that!
That's a picture of a movie star!
So?
No, you don't have any movie star. You wrote that yourself.
So what if I did? I've been to her dorm. I called her up. I've seen her movie 16 times.
I'm his girlfriend. I kiss him. I fuck him. I do stuff for him. You wouldn't even understand. Does she do that for you? Does she kiss you? Does she fuck you?
Get out of here.
You don't even have a girlfriend.
Get out!
Straight!
My dearest Jody, I'm humiliated by my weakness and my ignorance. Jody, I can change. I'll prove to you that I can change with one brave, historic act. I will win your love now and for all eternity. Love, John.
Thank you. go again. There you go again.
Thank you. shall be remembered. I am going to glory.
Look on the bright side, not on the sad side. Inside the bad side, something's good. This is your golden opportunity. You've been a preacher.
Take the one!
way to look back at your long years of public service and to conclude that as our president, you really bit the big one. Why do you think you big one? And I say, and you know what?
This cracks me up. I voted for you. Yes, I gave you my vote, my sacred democratic trust.
And you know what you did? You pissed all over it. Well, what the hell, guys like you, you piss all over everything. You piss all over the country, you piss all over yourself, you piss all over me. Yeah, yeah, I know. Sam, don't say it. You're my main man. Harsh country. You're the backbone of the nation. Sammy, shout it! I'm walking, all right? I'm walking, and you're my man. Hey, you see the papers like that? Grandma, the Captain Crane, Sue Rich Closes, Jersey Bitches, Shorty Prince, Spice, Howard Johnson. What the hell is going on here, kid? It wasn't supposed to be like this. Wasn't, but it is. Schmucks like you, you're telling us it isn't. Everything's fine, it's great, it's military. What military? What's a burden, Dick? What can we do? You want to make things better? How? Well, let's hold an election. Great. The Democrat says he'll fix everything, the Republicans fucked up. The Republican says he'll fix everything, the Democrats fucked up. Who's telling us the truth? Who's lying? Someone's lying. Who? Yes, are we? But deep down, we know that we don't know. How can we? Oil embargo, megatons of holes in the ozone. Who can understand this crap? We need to believe, to trust, like little kids, that someone wants what's best for us. Someone's looking out for us, that someone loves us. Do they? No, they lie to us. That I am always right, that I am always wrong, that I am always a fucking hammering! And when we realize they're lying, really realize it in our gut, then we get terrified. Then we get scared. Like children waking in the dark, we don't know where we are. I had a bad dream. Mommy, Daddy, Sammy had a nightmare. And then Daddy comes in and takes me in his arms and says, it's okay, Sammy. Daddy's here. I love the kid. And Mommy doesn't, but I do. And then Mommy comes and holds me tight and says, I got you, Bubba. I'm here for you. The Daddy isn't. And then where are we? What do? Who do we believe? Who do we trust? What do we do? We do the only thing we can do. We kill the president.
Oh,
shopkeepers get murdered, or when a president gets killed, when Julius Caesar got killed, he was assassinated.
And the man who did it,
Brutus.
Ah, well, you know his name.
Brutus assassinated Caesar, what, 2,000 years ago? And here's a high school dropout with $1.25 an hour job in Dallas, Texas, who knows who he was. And they say fame is fleeting.
This is stupid. I'm up here on the sixth floor. What would I do? Throw school books at him?
What's in the package?
What package?
Package. You brought in the work today. What's in it?
Curtain rods.
Are you sure?
Sure, I'm sure. Maria wanted me.
The man lick a cup cut a 6.5 millimeter cutting range 900 yards.
Sight's already been adjusted.
Who are you?
My name is John Wilkes Booth, Lee.
John Wilkes Booth shot Abraham Lincoln.
Attention has been paid. All your life, you wanted to be a part of something. You are finally gonna get your wish!
What is this?
This is a past you never have, the future you'd abandon. It's called history, Lee.
My name is Charles Guiteau. I assassinated President James Garfield.
Leon Czolgosz, William McKinley.
Sam Vick, I'm gonna try to kill Vick Nixon.
John Hinckley, Ronald Reagan.
Annette Brown,
Mary Jane Moore,
Gerald Ford,
Sagara.
I don't get this.
It's simple, Lee.
You are going to bring us back
and make us possible.
We're in your debt, old boy.
It's good for you, Lee.
What's he doing?
No,
I'm sorry. I don't think I'll have to cut a pass here, but you can't leave now.
No, watch me.
You have a responsibility here.
No, do you?
Yeah,
I'm responsible to me and to no one else.
Not anymore. 50 years from now, let's still be arguing about the grass and knoll or the mafia or some human caravan on stocking vest. Well, this, right here, right now, this is the real conspiracy, and you are part of it.
Out of my way.
Listen to me, Lee. You have to do this now. You won't get another chance.
So what? So I'll do something else. I'll shoot my wife. I'll shoot my kids. I won't shoot anyone.
Who cares?
So no, who cares? I care! You stupid fool! We all care! Haven't you been taking it for God's sake? Oh, you stuck up back in Jesse was not educated! I'm sorry. Sorry. John. Yes, sir. John, the legal aid, we had a dog. What was his name?
Tex.
The Marines in at the radar school.
What? The Naval Air Station, Jacksonville, Florida.
The KGB official, he briefed him in the credit. What was his name?
Admiral Ryan. Lieutenant Colonel Boris Kutsov.
18 years from now, when John tries to assassinate President Reagan, they're going to search his room.
And you know what they're going to find?
Every book about you ever written.
Can I have your autograph?
Take a look, Lee. You know what that is. That's a banner, the land where any kid can grow up to be president. This shining city, Lee, it shines so brightly about the shape of life. But in here, this is America, too. The mass of men lead lives of quiet desperation. An American said that, and he was right. But let me tell you something. There are no lives. Quiet desperation in here.
Desperation, yes. Quiet, I don't think so. Not today. Today, we are going to make a joyful noise.
This is the big one. You are the big one. You are the one who's gonna sum it all up and blow it all wide open. I have seen the future, Lee. And you are it.
And now the motorcade is turning into Elm Street. There's someone holding up a banner, all the way from JFK. The president is smiling and waving as his car heads for DP Plaza, where it will swing past the Texas Book Depository and onto
They will hate you with a passion. Imagine, people have passionate feelings about Lee, Harvey, Oswald.
Someone help me!
Come on! Ti prego, che il subito!
Please, we beseech you, noi siamo disparati e
sparati. We are the homeless ones, the lost ones.
Viviamo la nostra vita di sirio.
Viviamo la vita di sirio.
Ripatriati nella nostra terra!
Expatriate in our own country. Siamo portati a cinque dalla nascita di sperare.
We drift from birth to death, despairing.
Consolarevi!
Mark! Attraverso le tue possibilità.
Possiamo sparare.
We dare to hope.
Attraverso le proiezioni, ravvivandoci, dandoci senso.
You and your idea of reviving, giving meaning.
Ognuno della nostra vita, della nostra
vita. Our action, give a meaning.
Frustrazioni.
Our frustrations fall away.
I nostri sogni profondi diventano
fair. Fondest dreams come true.
Sì,
sì. Attraverso te, siamo nuovi nati.
We are reborn.
We need you, Lee.
Now you were just footnotes in a history book.
Disappointed office seeker. Strange immigrant. Thank God, us after.
You were a bunch of freaks.
With you, we are a force of history.
We become immortal.
Finally, we belong
to one another.
To the nation of the age.
Bring us together, babe.
You think you can't connect to us?
You think you'll help us? Empower us! It's in your grasp, Lee.
All you have to do is move your little finger.
You can close the New York Stock Exchange.
Shut down the schools in Indonesia.
In Florence, Italy, a woman will leap from the Duomo watching a picture of your picking and cursing your name.
Your wife will weep.
His wife will weep.
The bottom will grief, grief beyond imagination.
Spare.
The death of innocence.
The bitter burden that you bear.
Their truth you carry, you are to share them with the world.
You have the power of Pandora's box.
Open it.
Damn me.
My foreman.
He must be a
man.